Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you are new to the channel, hi, my name is Anjum Sheikh and I make videos related to study, vlogs, productivity and many more. So today's video is going to be about note taking. Many of you were asking me about the note taking method that I use in the comment section below. So I thought I would make an independent video about that. So if you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, also comment down below what you think about the video. I would be really happy to know your responses. So today's video is going to be in two parts. First one, is note taking important? And second point, how to take notes. So talking about the first question, that is note taking important? So this question really depends on yourself. For example, I am the type of person, I really like to write down things so that I would remember them later. You would be a type of person that really likes to read things, or just by underlining you would remember things. So you just have to see for yourself what suits you better and you can just follow that. I am a type of person, as I said, I like to write down things, so I make a lot of notes and then I also make a shorter notes from them that will be easy for revision. So this is the method that I use. You would be a person that just reads books, so you can just focus more on reading and reading that back to back again. So if you are a person that likes to write, you can just write down notes one or two times as you prefer. So I just wanted to give you an advice, even if you are a person that really likes to read things, I just want to say you that you should also make shorter notes that would be easy for revision, and because you would have a physical document that would remember you about the hard work that you did and you would have a satisfaction of completing that chapter. So yeah, this is the whole answer of the first question, that is note taking important. So now let's just talk about the second question, that was how to make notes. So before me showing you the note taking method that I use now, I just want to take you through the evolution that I have been in the note taking method. So now let's just go back to the beginning of my preparation around 4 months ago. So back then I did not know how to make notes or how to make effective notes. So I just bought a notebook from market and I used to jot down everything that the teacher said or I ever read in the notebook into that book, and that was just a chunks of paras and paras. And now when I saw back into that notebooks, I thought that it is very difficult to revise from them. So that was the totally wrong method of note taking. So this is the first notebook that I made for notes. This was for geography, and as you can see, there are just chunks and chunks of paragraphs that I wrote during the lectures or in the first read of the notebook. So this is totally the wrong method of note taking. I just wanted to show you the wrong method also because you should learn from the mistakes that I did. So later on, I just shifted to loose papers. I started to use the loose papers and I started to write down notes into that. And I really think that is a very good and effective method of note taking. So now I would just show you the note taking method that I use now. Before knowing how to make notes, the important question is when to take notes. So you should never take the notes after the first read. You should just do the first read, take a basic idea of the subject. After that, you should do a second read after a few days, and after the second read, you should just do a quick paper analysis so that you know what type of questions are asked in the exam. And based on that analysis and the second read, you should start making the notes. So your notes should just be a concise form of what you read, or you should highlight the things that you don't know or you think is important in that chapter. So now I would explain you how I take notes. So after the notebook method, I just shifted to this method. As you can see here, I have just linked two sentences with an arrow in between. This was also a good method, but it was not that much effective. I mostly use this method for history, but I just stopped using this, and now I'll explain you the current method of noting that I use in few minutes. So those were the noting method that I stopped using. Now I use two types of note taking method. Now I would explain you both of them. The first one is the daily notes. So the pages that I use for daily notes are these A4 size papers. This is the Matrix multi-purpose paper in 70 GSM. You can get this in any stationery store near you. So I like to organize my notes in the binder. So I just punch the pages before I write on them. After that, I just draw a line besides the punching holes, because the space above and below the punching hole is not visible when you keep these notes in the file. After that, I just leave some space in the left side and draw a line there, and also same for the bottom. I would explain why I do this in some time.
So this is the layout of notes that I use. As you can see, I have left some space above also because I have to write the title of the chapter that I am studying now. So first I choose a color code for that chapter. After that I use a marker to write the title of the chapter that I want to study. Then I use a sketch pen of same color to write the subtopics. If I have something important to write below that subtopics, I use this Luxure fine tips. These are really good and I usually like to go with the color code that I started in the beginning of the chapter. So after that I just use a normal blue ballpoint pen to write the main body of the notes. You just have to write the key points or the points that are really important or the points that you cannot remember by just reading into the notes. You can just write the points one below the other or you can just use a dash in between them. So in the left side of the page, I just write the facts about that notes. For example, any year or any important name related to that thing would be written down in the left side of the page so that it would be very much easy to revise the facts related to that notes. This is a note-taking method that I prefer because this note-taking works for me. I don't know if it would work for you. You just have to see for yourself. If it works for you, well and good. So now let's just talk about the part that we have left below the page. So this would be left for the summary. So when you revise this note after a few months, you just have to write down a summary of the whole page below in your own words. So later when you are doing the second revision or third revision, you just have to read the summary part of the notes. So you can also skip the whole summary part also if it does not suit you. So later on, if I think that I have missed some point in the note taking, then I would just write that point on these sticky notes and then stick this on the notes. So this is the whole layout of the note taking method that I use. You can see this, if it suits you, you can follow this. If not, you can see what suits you better and you can follow that. So now I would just show you the notes that I have made in this layout. These are the notes for economics. So now I would just explain you a note related to this green revolution. As you can see, in the left side of the page, I have just written the most important point related to green revolution. Below that, I have just written the Mexican varieties of the wheat, the names of those varieties. Then I have also written the year in which the new strategy started. And below that, I have also written that the rice production was more as compared to the wheat production, but wheat was also catching up. So these are the most important points that I have to know in the green revolution that could be asked in the exam. So as you can see here also, I have written the percentage rise in the output of cereal. Like this only, I have written all the important numbers or the important names or anything important in the left side of the page that would be most likely to ask in the exams. So just by reading the left side of my page, I should be having an idea of all the facts that are in that notes. Even after this, if I feel that it's not much enough, so I would just read the main body of that notes later. So that was the first type that I use. I also use mind maps for revision because I have to make a condensed form of notes from the earlier bulky notes that I had. So as you can see here, this is a mind map for geographical cycle theory. I have written the title in between and around the title I have written all the subtopics and I have also highlighted the subtopics. I have made all the mind maps in just the same pattern. So mind maps is a really good method for revision because you get all the information related to that one topic in just one page. I also use flashcards for revision. You can see I have mentioned about the flashcards in one of the videos. I would just link that up in the iCard. You can also see that if you want to. So yeah, this is the layout that I use for mind maps. Even it could be the daily notes or in the mind maps or also in the flashcards, the important point about note taking is not to write the whole sentence that you read. You just have to write the keywords and just make a dash in between those keywords. You should never write the whole sentence in your notes. As you can see here also, I have never written the whole sentence. I have just written the important points. So these are the note taking methods that I use. I know these are a little bit time consuming, but it works for me very good. And at the end of the day, the target is to just understand things. So you could be a person that just reads and understand everything, so you can just do the reading.
So thank you so much for watching the video. If you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And if the video was helpful for you, then let me know in the comment section below. I would meet you guys in the next video. Until then, stay home, stay safe. Bye.